Hi, I'm Greg. I'm from Scribe Flooring. Today I'm going to be having a look at the HK saw, the HK55 from Vegtool. This saw comes in a HK and also a HKC, which is the cordless version. Not a big fan myself of the cordless because I love my dust extraction because I'm always working inside. We're working in a penthouse today and we're installing fairly long boards. These are 3.1 meter long boards. And normally the way we would cut these is not with the CMS 55 that's over there, but we would actually use our TS55 plunge saw with a short rail and a square. And the way we do it is we stack up a big pile of boards like I have done here, and we would flip the board over that we're ready to cut, we'd measure it, and we'd just cut it, we'd set the rail on it with the square and we'd cut it. Now, while it works great because we're not swinging large boards around in a tight spot or, you know, somewhere where you can actually create a lot of damage if you bang a wall or bang a chandelier or, heaven forbid, one of those brass lifts over there. Vegtool will come out with this, which is a saw and a rail that actually attach. So, as you can see, the saw attaches to the rail. It's spring-loaded so it comes back. And when I first saw the video of this, I was over the moon, simply because of the types of installs that we do. I'm going to give it a little go and show you how it cuts. I'm not even going to measure this board, I'm just going to put a cut through it just to show you exactly what we do. Let's just say that we've ended up with a mark that's there. We need this large piece here. We sit the saw on the mark. Okay, with the HK saw, the beautiful part about it is the FSK rail, which is attached to the saw. A couple of different lengths. The 250 will cut 250 wide by 50mm thick. Obviously the 420, same thing, 420mm long, 50mm thick. So these boards are 220mm, 20mm thick. No problem for the 250 rail, that's what we've been using to do our square cuts. But I've actually got some angle cuts, which are 14.5 degrees. As you can see on the back here, we've got a fixed guide and an adjustable guide. It's as simple as loosening it off, adjusting the guide to 14.5 degrees for what I require. And I'm going to swap the saw over. So you just move the saw forward a touch, pull the toggle, the saw just slides off the back of the rail. And to attach it to the new rail, just slide it straight on, ready to go. So we'll do our 14.5 degree cut. All right, just with the saw, I've unplugged everything and I've taken it off the rail just to show you a few little tricky and cool things about this saw, just awesome. You can set the depth at the back here for your depth of cut, and it's got both, like the new 55R saw, it's got the both the guide for with the rail and without the rail. So you can set that. The other thing it's got is a little thumb guide here for the blade guard, which is pretty awesome. And the coolest thing that I've seen on a saw for a long time is the blade guard's actually got the curve splitter built into the blade guard. So when the blade guard drops back down onto the timber, you can see that the curve splitter's there in action. Now, the other thing that this saw does, you know, you think that it's just a normal circular saw, you set it to the depth and that's it. But it actually has another little cool feature, which has got a little release catch here, which lets the saw come right up and actually turns the saw into a plunge saw. So then you can actually set it on your rail or on your floor, you've set the depth, and then you can plunge the saw in just like the TS saw, which is absolutely cool. I'll just hang it off the side here, because once you push it down and actually reaches what you've set the saw at, it'll lock into place. And that's it, it'll stay down like that. And we're gonna do a couple of rail cuts on the original Fez Tool rails and show you how that works with this doing a plunge cut. Love it. Something that's going to be coming out that's new, not sure, I'm just speculating, but it's hose ends. It's a locking hose end. So this is a whole new end for my 27mm hose. Basically what happens is you put it in and you twist it and it's locked, similar to the plugger. So no more hoses falling off, not that they ever did anyway. Really cool. All right, thanks for watching. Love the saw. See you next time.